members of Calvary know that I have four horses, and they're just around the corner from here. I had to run and feed them in between services. I'm going to tell you about my neighbors who live next door. So I had some new neighbors move in, Johnny and Karen, and they've been really good to my horses. They've like cornered the market on carrots. They feed those horses all the time. In the summertime, Karen will put like fruit and freeze it, hang it over the fence so the horses can nibble on that. But she's gone over the top. When I got there just before the 6 o'clock service, on the fence, four stockings. No wonder my horses ignore me. They like that. I only tell you that because I realized at 4 o'clock that I had left up the Advent banners. And I intended to take them down, but I knew the horses wouldn't wait. And then it occurred to me that maybe they were left up for a reason. I've been kind of nostalgic recently. I've been looking through old files of old sermons. Well, actually, I've been here so long, I figured I could trot out some old ones and you wouldn't know. But I saw the Christmas Eve services from years ago. So I was an intern here in 1989 under Pastor Eric Schultz, a wonderful man, a great gift of God. And he had a way of doing Christmas Eve services different from how we do them now. He would have a thematic thing, and you'd get up and do a little thematic thing, and then you would do a song, and another theme, and a song. So I thought, well, let's do that tonight. Kind of an honor of Pastor Eric, who is dwelling in that place of perfection that is truly with us even now. So what do we do while we wait? What song do we sing? Sometimes the night is so long. You don't think the dawn is ever going to come. Your anxious thoughts keep going around and around in your head so that rest is denied you. You just wish it would be over. I think the song we need at that point is a Christmas lullaby, Ave Maria. We just close our eyes in the beautiful harmonies. We rest into the promise of that song. But there's also a negative side to waiting. When we wait too long for things to happen, and we become complacent and just allow things to go on and on and on. And I think at those times we need a different song. At those times we need an orchestra. Oh, come, O faithful. We need all of the instruments getting us off our seat, let's say it that way, so that we move into this world with some kind of courage. But we can't do that on our own. We can only do that together, and we can only do it together because God didn't wait until the world was right to enter into our reality. God came when the need was desperate to enter into our humanity. Now I know the lullaby says, no crying he makes, but I need a fussy Jesus. I need a Jesus who cries impatiently for his mother's milk because he's hungry. I need a Jesus who's weak, subject to viruses and colds. I need a Jesus who's real. And then a Jesus who grows up and is angry about the corruption in the church in his day and does something about it by overturning tables. I need a Jesus who weeps at the tomb of his friend. I need a Jesus who lays down his life and dies for those who could care less about him. And only then will I be healed of my complacency. Only then will I be healed of those things that are wrong inside of me. Only then will I be healed in such a way that I might decide to make a difference. The song of healing, then, compels us into a place of hope. Now, hope is not about hope that someday things will be better. Hope says, we will not wait for things to get better, but rather we'll do something about it. We can all do that together, but we can also do it individually. I don't know what your plans are for presents this Christmas, but don't you think we've got enough stuff? So I'm going to spoil my daughter and son-in-law's Christmas. Once again, Mary, I got you funds, microloans for women in Indonesia. Aaron, you got to go. For a village in Africa. Your son, Elliot, got some chickens. Now, don't worry, I also got you something else, but that makes a difference for people who have nothing. We can give so much away, so much away. And when we do that, we have a glimpse of what's coming. Nothing can stop it. And it won't be a day of fearful judgment. Listen, Jesus is coming back the same way he came the first time. As one who reached out to the outcast, who welcomed the stranger, who didn't judge, but loved unconditionally. That's the future, and nothing can stop it. Listen, we are already eternal creatures, experiencing the beauty and joy and mystery of eternity. When we choose to live that future in our present, we sing the song of peace. And if we would sing that long and loud, I believe we could convince others to live into that same kind of peace. So let's make this a Merry Christmas. Not wait for the future. No, let's pray.